the group.
I have no doubt that is the case, Ethan. We're going to talk about last year's game in just a little while, but let's first of all start about with the Limerick defence, because they are so difficult to break down. And yet we saw Waterford pop in for two late goals a couple of weeks ago.
Yeah, well, listen, I think there's a perception out there in relation to Limerick, and they're so deep. So you see Declan Hannan here. That's not him being a deep line centre-back. It's not a sweeper. That's him playing centre-back traditionally. It's just a Cork have withdrawn out the field. So that's where he holds. Now you see him here, okay? Sean Finn is a spare man back there. Look at Declan hand up. He's past the middle of the field. He's on the opposite 65. He's roaring for the ball. Keane Lynch spots him. Ball across to Declan and over the bar. There's a goal chance on there. He's inside the opposite 45. So it's not a case that they just sit deep. Look at Barry Nash here. He knows that there's enough bodies back to defend. So he obviously has a license to go. It's 5v4 of Cork forwards. And he's gone once he sees a bit of space. Look at that, if it's given to his right. No interest in tracking him. Ball comes to Keane Lynch. Pops it off to Barry. And again, over the bar in the middle of the field. So that's both Declan and Barry after doing that. On the flip side of that, just look where Declan is here now. He actually moves out of that sixth position. He gets turned around. There's no spare man back there. And all of a sudden then, Cork have broken a line and they're in. Shane Barrett is running the whole way in. The ball comes across to him. Again, there's nobody back there. And it probably should have been a goal. So my point is, I suppose, is that, you know, Limerick don't play a sweeper. They don't sit deep. They just hold their positions. But opposition teams seem to go to field. But just going back to Barry Nash's point, I'd say when Liam was playing in the 90s with Len Gaynor and Nick English, if you took off up the field like that, I'd say they'd been roaring at you to get back. So it just shows where the game has gone.
But the end of your piece there, you're suggesting they are vulnerable at times at the back then?
Well, Declan pushed farther out the field there than he probably shouldn't have had. They had nobody back, so when the opposition got inside him, then there was space.
Is that a new approach from Limerick, though? Are they not pushing up further from defence now?
I don't know, is it a new approach to them, but what I'm saying is that when they realise that they've sufficient cover back, they're going up the field. And when you see Barry Nash doing that, it's just another string to their bow, really.
The only team we really have seen get close to them, Liam, was your tip for 35 minutes, 10 points ahead at half-time. What way did you take them on?
Yeah, well, you know, as you said, 2:16 in the first half we got against them, and we were anxious that they'd put the ball down, so we had a four-man half-forward line, and we managed to create bodies around the breaking ball. Was a big part of our game, and trying to get our hands on the ball, but being very, very calculated when we got it. Of course, no better man than Cahill to ride the tackler to come out, but you'll watch here our positioning. So Jason Ford has come out from the 11 position, and he's filled that space in the middle of the park, and we wanted to try and get players out there and know that we had an extra man to half forward line, and it worked very, very much to our advantage. And again, we had two men inside, so we were happy to let them out as far as the 45-yard line and have structure right so that we had every man covered, because when it went down then, we were able to create that plus one scenario. You can see here Ronan Maher is outside the play and he's free. Cahill wins it and he's looking for Ronan because he knows he's out there. Now again, you've got to play a little bit high risk here, because you know you're playing a dangerous game trying to get in, but at least then you can try and work the ball up. Barry Heffernan can get his head up. We have to have heads up hurling, trying to find our forwards, and Jake manages to get the ball in across to Jason Ford, and you see Limerick, they're very much protecting the D, so there is pockets of space to be available, but you got to play a really, really high risk game. Jason ended up getting six in play. I think Noel McGrath will try and find that space in this field today.
When he does try to do that, is he going to try to force Declan Hannan then into doing something he's less comfortable with? Although Declan Hannan he plays the same role regardless of what the opposition
does. No, he does,
but they
very much want to keep their half-back then well structured, so that they've got a really good protective layer. And if you can try and draw them out, you have a chance. Because even with Tadhg De Borca in the first round against Waterford, when Noel came into that pocket of space out there, he got four from playing that first half. So I think they might try and play that, but it's to try and get the ball up to there and get it into his hands to the challenge, because Limerick are ferocious in the tackle.
Can Noel McGrath do some damage, Shane, today for Tip?
He can, but I think what you did last year in the Munster final was top class, and it showed obviously in the performance. But I do think Limerick's work rate definitely dipped, because by allowing Jason Ford get the ball, I'd say the Limerick midfield and half forward line inside in the dressing room at half time were told, I'd say, no uncertain terms, that they weren't working hard enough. So if Tip tried to do the same today, which I suspect they will, I do think that they might be swarmed straight away.
Who's going to take the freeze today? Is it going to be this man?
Well, I would expect it's Noel, because when Jason went off against Waterford in Mulch Park, it was Noel that came up and he put two frees over the bar. So I'd expect Noel will take on the free taking duties today.
Everybody says that we all know how Limerick play. Everybody knows how Limerick play. Is that actually the case? Will you take us through what way you believe they play?
Well, I think this is a very these are two very good examples. So here Dermot Burns, now he's got 10 points in the championship to date, so it's not so often he drops them short. But normally when they drop short, that's an opportunity for the other team to get forward. But watch the way Garrod Hegarty manages to turn Conor Lehan. All of a sudden then they've got Mark Coleman is taken by Will Donoghue. And look at the reaction from when he turns over the ball. They thrive on turnovers. And here on the 21-yard line, they're allowed to get the ball out. That's their retention zone. They love to get the ball in the middle of the field because then they're able to give in good quality ball and they get it in inside. And in fairness, Aaron Gillan's movement from 13 and across to 15. Sean O'Donoghue does really well here. And I expect Cathal Barrett will be given this job to try and tie up Aaron Gillan today. So it doesn't finish up in the back of the net. But watch when Patrick Collins gets the ball. Watch the way Kyle Hayes, you know, they look at the pressure they're applying between Kyle Hayes and Keane Lynch here. And they just don't let you out. And like, if you're a wing back or a corner back up the field and you're seeing that coming from your forwards, I think that's the template. They're very good to transition ball inside. And when it breaks down, no better team to go and hunt the ball to get it back.
Dermot Burns has always been a top player for Limerick. We know that. Has he moved it on another level again this year?
He seems to have had done that, hadn't he, Joanne? I mean, his ball striking ability is something I've seen since we were 12 years of age. He's always been really good at that. His accuracy is unbelievable. His work rate is really, really good. But he knows with the distance that he has, the accuracy that he has, he can wait in the pocket, wait for that hand pass to come back. And he knows and has obviously been given the license to shoot as often as he can.
If we look at Tipperary, who are going to attempt to keep out so many of those men Liam was just talking about a little while ago, how do they do that? What do they show us against Clare that they're capable of it?
Not much, Joanne. I think they were very, very disappointing. So look at here, Ronan Maher. Okay, so similar to Declan, he's not playing deep. He's just playing the sixth role. The ball comes in. It is maybe James Quigley in tight as he should be. But look, there's no goal threat there whatsoever because he's minding his own position. Now, if you look at him here, look at the space that's left and right. There's Ronan Maher out in his own 65. The ball comes in left and right. If they leave that space to there, again, you can see Ian Galvin. Look at the space that, you know, that he's been afforded. They get a point out of that. Now, this is what I don't know. Really here, you can see the four Tipperary players. Seamus Kennedy, Barry Heffernan should be coming back here today for sure. Ronan then should be sitting. It looks to me as if they don't really know what they're doing. Look at Ronan Maher here then. He's out of position. John Conlon and two Tipperary players beside him. They don't track Joanne, and this is the big problem. Ronan is gone. Look, and keep looking at the two Tipperary players that were right beside John Conlon. He comes in here, and I don't actually even know how to explain this, to be honest with you, Joanne. It's a 3v2. The ball comes in. Peter Duggan puts it in the back of the net. I've looked at that enough times, and I can't even tell the viewers at home why there was 3v2 on that, so that'll tell you how bad it really was.
It's a rather stark contrast to the piece you showed just a moment ago with the Limerick players and their forwards putting so much pressure on the defences.
And like you'd have to think that group of players will learn from that, because you cannot have a situation where it's 2v2 inside and the Clare man coming in through the 65 with no other player in view. So I think the tip structure defensively will need to be a whole lot better today, because if we set up like that against Limerick today, I think, you know, it's all over. There'll be goals going in, but I would expect, you know, a lot of those guys are good players, and you know, but their positioning when Limerick have the ball is going to be critical. And I think their half forward line have to press really hard in that midfield sector to allow the half back to not get disconnected from the inside back line, because if they do, there's trouble ahead.
Liam, Ronan Maher is around long enough now at this stage. He knows when he looks back at that Clare game the last day, he shouldn't be going that far out the field and leaving the space in behind. So really, he should be sitting, shouldn't he?
Yeah, no question. But you know, the thing about Limerick does, you know, if you sit idle, they'll put the ball left and right here and they'll take you out of the game as well. So it's really about the pressure that's put on outside, I think, is going to be key.
Liam doesn't necessarily think that it'll be Ronan Maher who'll be in the sixth position, but we'll get to possible matchups in a little while. For now though, we'll get all the very latest team news with our commentators at the Gaelic Grounds. It's Anthony Daly and Jerk.
Thank you very much indeed, Joanne. Well, goalkeeper Nicky Quaid is facing tip opponents for the 10th time in the championship. He's come out on top 5 times already. His captain, Declan Hannan, is hoping to lift the Munster Cup this year for the 4th time, with loftier ambitions for later in the summer. There's a first championship start this afternoon for the talented Cathal O'Neill. He's picked at half forward, taking the place of the injured Keane Lynch. And recovered from injury is Kyle Hayes, the goal scorer against Cork, who will lead the Limerick attack. Tipperary's 5 changes for this match start in goal, where Barry Hogan takes over from his namesake Brian. There's a change at fullback as well, where Barry Heffernan is named. He figured in midfield, of course, in the last 2 matches, given the number 3 jersey today. All of which results in a new pairing in the centre of the park. It's Paddy Cadell alongside Michael Breen. Changes at wing forward as well, Conor Stakelham and Ger Brown on the flanks, with Paul Flynn from Killadangan included at left corner forward. Well, around about 30,000 people are here this afternoon, or expected here this afternoon, and you won't be surprised to hear that most of them are from Limerick. Anthony, they expect their team to deliver, will they?
They do, Ger, and they're liking having him back here at home again. I think, yeah, you listen to the two lads there, even sure you'd be saying, and I've never seen it as one-sided coming into a Limerick Tip game. Huge traditional rivals. I've never seen Limerick such strong favourites. The Tip people viewing and that are here will be hoping maybe that that leads to a small bit of complacency maybe, and that their lads can play much better than they did against Clare.
Tip very much up against it. It throws in here, of course, at 2 o'clock. In the meantime, back to Joanne.
Yeah, hopefully it'll be a lot closer than people seem to be predicting. If we can look at one aspect, we mentioned how John Kiely was talking about it doesn't matter who the player is, and Shane, you were saying that that's genuine, it doesn't matter what player is missing. And yet, when both of you were showing your pieces to do with Limerick, Liam's was saying, it was you, Shane said, and Keane Lynch pops it out, and Keane Lynch pops it out, and then Liam said, and Keane Lynch puts on the pressure. He features in so much of what Limerick does. Does it even, say from your point of view as the opposition manager, Liam, when you were doing a game plan for Limerick, how much of it actually revolved around Keane Lynch?
Oh, yeah, I mean, like, you know, he caught me in the Munster semi-final in 2020 because I thought Keane Lynch would start midfield and I had a man-marking job at him, and then he started centre-forward. And to be honest with you, it upset the makeup of our team. But last year, Dan McCormick was going back picking up Keane Lynch in the puck out. So we had a four-man half-forward and Jason would come out to the middle of the field. Dan would drop back to pick up Keane Lynch and Brendan was freed up to be the extra man. And we'd always work the extra man back in defence. So, you know, he does take a lot of minding because, like, he's a wizard. And even a few times in that first half when Limerick were somewhat sucking for air, the ball went out between himself and Dan. He plucked it out of the sky and put it over the bar. And he was massive in that game. So he's a big game player for him. His performances last year were of the highest order. But, you know, Limerick, Carl O'Neill is in. I think Keane gets a chance to freshen himself up because, like, he's had a very, very busy campaign between colleges and coming in with Limerick, played a lot of league matches as well. So actually it could be a blessing for Limerick down the line, because I think John Kiely feels he's got enough in the locker to get through Munster and maybe leave him sit for a few weeks.
And it is a big day for Cathal O'Neill, isn't it? There are a lot of expectations up, and it was interesting that John Kiely wasn't playing it down.
It is a big day, but I think, again, Jonathan was spot on. He has shown enough. I know he said the last 18 months he's probably on about training, but it's really this year where he's literally played every league game and has come on in all games as well. So he was really, really good the last day. It's a big game. He's probably the first young lad to come on and break into that group over the last couple of years. But he's a big boy. He's well able to look after himself. And what a day to get your starting debut here in the Gaelic Grounds. 30,000 people, Munster Championship. So, you know, it's great for him.
Absolutely. If we look at the key matchups, and most of them, they are on the Tipperary side, and they have to get them right. Would Aaron Gillan now be your main focus, yeah, and your own integrity?
Well, I'm only giving you my own experience. I mean, definitely Cathal Barrett, you know, was always told if Tony Kelly or Aaron Gillan appear on the inside line, he's a really, really good man marker. I thought he was very, very good against Desi Hutchinson last year, even in the Waterford match. So he really does thrive on that. And I think Craig Morgan and his size would suit a Graham Mulcahy. I think he'd be fine in that corner. I think the big one then is who picks up Keane Lynch.
Like Kyle Hayes,
Hayes. And the thing about Kyle Hayes is that he's got such pace. But, you know, Ronan can take him on physically, but he's been a real thorn in the Tipperary side. He's a man that's got big goals in the two Munster finals over the last
so
3 years.
So you think Ronan Maher will pick him up? Does that depend, even if he plays full forward
Ronan's very comfortable on the edge of the square, and you potentially have, like, Barry Heffernan, who would be very comfortable on somebody like Gerard Hegarty, because he matches him for size, and Seamus Kendi. So there's a lot of permutations at stake, but ultimately I think whoever picks up Aaron Gillan and Kyle Hayes are two big matchups, and I would see him being Cathal Barrett and Ronan Maher.
And Kyle Hayes, he will play at full forward, will he, Shane?
You'll have to read the programme, Joanne. you tried to catch me out now 2 weeks ago. You won't catch me out anymore.
You did that all by yourself. You let us know where Mr. Hayes was playing. He's named to start obviously at full forward, but you do expect he will actually start there.
I don't see any reason why not. I just to go back to Liam's point, I think Ronan Maher, exception hurler, I rate him extremely high. I think if he goes back in full back, and if there is a bit of space there and the ball gets delivered into Kyle, physically he may be able to to match him, but from a pace perspective, if Kyle turns and goes, but in saying that, there aren't too many backs out there who are going to be able to manage that anyway.
I presume you're both going for a Limerick win. How close do you think Tip can get to them, Liam?
Well, I think it's really all about their performance and the resolve. I think for Tip, it's really the first 20 minutes is really important in this, Joanne.
And do they need goals?
I think they will need goals. And they've created loads of goal opportunities in the first two rounds, but this is a different animal they're playing today in this Limerick team. They're an exceptional team operating at the top of their game so far in this championship. But I think for Tip, I'd expect them to come with a real, real strong energy and spirit, and let's see where that takes them.
Yeah, I think, you know, everything goes towards a big Limerick win, Joanne.
It certainly does, especially when you see the amount of green here in the Gaelic grounds. Let's head over to our commentators, Anthony and Ger.
Thank you again, Joanne. Perfect day weather-wise, certainly here in Limerick City. These counties have been rivals down the years, as you've been hearing. This is their 74th time meeting in the championship. And such is the striking contrast between them right now. John Kiley's team doing so well. Limerick side has dominated Hurling since the breakthrough year for them in 2018. And their run of success only halted briefly in 2019 when Tipperary lifted the Liam McCarthy Cup. Limerick 11 games unbeaten and seemingly unbeatable. Tip's last win in the championship occurred here. It was last July against Clare. That man was playing, Seamus Calnan, the day of the controversial penalty. Anthony, he's one of those badly missed. They've been struck down badly through absentees and injuries.
They sure have. I mean, I don't think there's any way Cullum thought when he was taking up the job that this is the starting 15 he'd be looking at. Realistically, probably there was rumours in the air that Brendan was going to be maybe stepping aside, but other than that, he'd expect to have most of them barring an injury. So, look, it's a tall order, but they played well down in Waterford and he'd be looking for something like that again.
A roar from the crowd. Teams meeting for the first time since last year's Munster final. Liam Gordon of Galway, he was in charge. He was the ref in 2020, the championship meeting of these teams. At that time, Tiff were the All-Ireland champions and Limerick were the Munster champions.
It's just straight away, you see changes. Dylan Kirk onto midfield. Ronan Maher, as Liam suggested, gone back to full-back, picking up Kyle Hayes. No, Kyle Barrett is picking up Kyle Hayes, I think, and Ronan has gone back and Aaron Gillan.
And Tip go into their first attack, or attempt to do so, with Cher Brown playing it forward, looking for Noel McGrath, trying to control it there, but in the end it's Declan Hannan who's able to touch it back as far as the ever-present Sean Finn. Down into space, Tip have the extra man back there, but it's not necessary just now. Ball out of play, Seamus Kennedy able to go across and take it. Breeze blowing down, whatever breeze there is today is blowing across towards the people on that far side of the field. Declan Hannan will be looking to dominate the exchanges in the middle of the park for Limerick, as he's done so often in the past. Taken well here, Michael Breen, can he exert a big influence? They need a big physical performance from the likes of Breen. Dylan Quirk there, hooked. And that one's slipped out over the sideline again, so the sideline takers over there busy in the opening 60 seconds. Garrod Hagerty going across now. Hagerty playing today in his 29th ever championship match. William O'Donoghue and Dara O'Donovan, by the way, have switched numbers. Ger Brown hitting this one, looking for the opening score. He's got it as well. Nicely done. Just under 90 seconds are gone.
Yeah, great start for Ger Brown. Really set the world on fire when he came on against Clare with 1-3, and great work there from Paul Flynn in the corner.
That was very
him up and onto him over there.
That puck out was very easily taken by Garrod Hagerty. Then he became a bit casual, lost it, but they've got to get back again now, Limerick. Cathal O'Neill getting his first touch over as far as Dara O'Donovan, and Donovan fires it in with his customary accuracy, and the teams are level.
Yeah, Jordan, trademark, as the lads showed in their analysis and the build-up, you just can't, you have to have eyes in the back of your head for these Limerick fellas, the way they move, and you can't allow him to get that much space over there, Dara Donovan.
Limerick trying to press up on the tip puck out immediately. That was Jake Morris trying to get to it. Seamus Kennedy now, in then came Dylan Quirk. Ended up on the ground, free kick, a free hit to Tipperary. Kyle Hayes will be a highly influential member of this Limerick team, I'm sure, again, in there at full forward.
We were wondering who'd hit these, Gerald, but watching the warm-up, it was very clear that Noel McGrath was the man to step up, so it's not an easy one to start. It's central, but it's a long way back.
11th time facing Limerick in the championship, looking for a good start, and he gets it as well. He'll be very, very pleased with that one. As you say, Anthony, it was a long way out.
Great strike, yeah. Beautiful striker, the ball. And another interesting one is Paddy Cadell has come back, wing back, to pick up Tom Morrissey.
Where he's played in the past so many times. That time it was Tipperary who allowed Limerick to take the short puck out. Again, the referee signalling a foul there by one of the Limerick players. I think it was Kyle Hayes. Free to Tipperary once again from deep in their own half. This time Noel McGrath just saying to his team captain Ronan Maher, you have a go at this one. Right on his own 45 metre line. Looking for one to play into the forwards. Or is he going to go for it? He has had a go, but he's put it wide. Not too much wrong with that one.
No, close, but sometimes then you feel, is it a wasted chance? Should have been let in around, but they're very well structured tip so far. Ger Brown is doing an awful lot of roaming, and maybe Limerick struggling to wonder where his movement is.
Limerick trying to play in between the lines. Garrod Hagerty down here towards Aaron Gillard. Gets away from his marker, who's Cathal Barrett. Gillard's first shot at the target. He's razor sharp. Just needs the slightest bit of space.
Yeah, brilliant ball up from Hagerty and Gillan. First run in Cathal Barrett, and such form he showed the last day, and he has continued on that right from the get-go.
Level again. Garrod Hagerty trying to chip it up to himself there. Didn't quite work out for him yet. A little casual again. And a bit of a swipe there, which the referee penalises. And once again, it's going to be a free hit. This time it'll be to Limerick.
Yeah, it gets maybe Seamus Kennedy with a little bit of a wild pull. No, there wasn't Seamus. It was Barry Heffernan, I think, so yeah, he's just not on the ball, so he gets a little ticking, and he'll have to be careful from that.
Liam Gordon from Galway making the notes. His linesmen today, by the way, are Patrick Murphy and also Sean Stack. Dermot Burns has scored 6 points in each of the two championship matches already this season. Looking to get off to a flyer here, and he puts Limerick in front.
It's been a feature, Ger, as well, when his accuracy from these long-range frees is incredible. He's hitting them much lower than in other seasons, and they're just going over the black spot, maybe 3-4 foot.
Tiff trying to do something with their own puck out, but it's mopped up at the back there by Mike Casey, helped out here by Declan Hannan. Breaks through the tackle. He's got a couple of players there. Tipperary had gone in towards the middle of the field, leaving a couple of men in behind them. Dara O'Donovan feeding it across here towards Tom Morrissey. Bit of work to do, first of all, to get onto possession here. Dylan Quirk trying to close him down. Can't do so. That's expertly done. This is brilliant.
Yeah, brilliant score, Ger. And the pass was just that little bit maybe overcooked to him, but he did really well to compose himself, recover. Beautiful score off his left. Looking for a bit of form, I'd say, Tom, and all those sort of scores are big helps.
Four shots so far by Limerick, and four scores as well. This one touched down to Noel McGrath. Feeds it forward, tried to do so. Sean Finn reads it, however, and then has the awareness to pick out Barry Nash. Taken down. It's Tipperary, however, who get in quickly with the challenges. Can they win it? They can't. Limerick. Eventually, it's Noel McGrath. Goes back. Puts a bit of pressure here on Seamus Kennedy. Aaron Gillan pressurising him. Fierce intensity being shown by Limerick early on. Tipperary trying to get into their stride. Barry Heffernan sweeping it forward here. That's a good ball. Taken down neatly. It's Kyo. And that one is high and over. Nicely done by Tipperary this time. Mark Kyo with the score.
And superb work back the field as well. Seamus Kennedy didn't panic. It wasn't too pretty to watch Joe going back towards his own goal. But they worked it to Barry Heffernan. And a great ball inside. And Kyo had a lot of space in there.
Time and again, Garrod Hagerty is moving into good positions and picking up that Limerick puck out. Dermot Burns feeding it forward here. Gillan in there. Gillan! Back of the net. It's only been on the ball twice and he's got a goal and a point already. This goal coming in the eighth minute and it's his tenth in the championship.
Yeah, familiar pattern. I'm not so sure Burns is letting it in, but we probably couldn't trust him. But Seamus Kennedy just caught the wrong side of you. Can't let him behind you. He's so knacky at that. And he's a player, as I just touched on a minute ago, that's really, really on form. And Cathal Barrett has gone back to pick him up now. Somewhere along the wire, there was cross wires there, so they didn't want that kind of a matchup. And fatal mistake.
Already 4 points between them. Mike Casey knocking it out as far as Cathal O'Neill. What a day for him to start his first championship match. His third ever game to play in the championship for Limerick. All the way over towards Dara O'Donovan. Quickly forward. Not a good ball this time. Mopped up by Seamus Kennedy. Sweeping into the hands here of Michael Breen. And that's driven away rather aimlessly. And it's another wide by Tipperary. Limerick so slick. Tipperary wasteful.
Yeah, and what I thought, look at the space again here, Ger, this is criminal.
This is in over the head of the defenders for Cathal O'Neill to strike and Cathal O'Neill to put this first one wide for Limerick.
Well, it's just too much space altogether, Ger. I don't know who was meant to be picking him up. There's a bit of confusion going on because they're so flexible. Kyle Hayes is playing very deep at the moment and they're finding it hard just to get a handle with the movement.
Ronan Maher takes his own puck out and gets it forward. Dylan Quirk, and then helped out by Noel McGrath. McGrath striking it up and putting it to the left, and that's another one gone the wrong side of the upright there. Got three wides already, 3 points on the board, but they're trailing. They surrender the puck out again, straight to Mike Casey. Limerick able to build. Declan Hannan, little block on it by Noel McGrath. Runs on towards Will O'Donoghue. Flicked out as far as Dermot Burns. He can rifle it over from here. Man of his stature and ability. This one he puts wide. Their second.
And they're two easy shots by Cathal O'Neill and Dermot Burns' standards. And they'll be nailing them if they get that much space going forward. So Tip have to get a handle on them.
Ger Brown looking for a second point in this match. He's done really well. Two possessions, two shots, 2 points. He's keeping Tip moving along well.
Vital score, yeah, just badly needed. Joe Brown, as you said, has taken up from where he finished off against Clare.
Well, he's a player who maybe struggled in the last year or so to just nail down a spot on this team. Doing well here is Cathal O'Neill. Drives it very high. But again, outside the right-hand post and a missed opportunity. He's had two shots. Real hint of his inexperience, but the great talent that he possesses as well. And an under 20 player who should have been playing last Wednesday against Tipperary. It was a very, very good under 20 game, but because he's played championship, he can't play under 20. Meanwhile, it's Ger Brown again. Target practice. He's missed one.
Yeah, but credit where it's due, Ger. I can't be just saying that the Limerick lads are finding space all the time. And Ger Brown now has won a couple of very easy possessions, and he normally scored that, and a throw by Hannan now, so free in chance to close it.
You'd expect a bit more from the puck outs here, challenges and marking and picking up. It's just not happening.
Yeah, and Dermot Burns and Declan Hannan were having a long chat after the last possession, who was meant to go out, and there was a miscommunication. Chance for Noel now to bring it back to two. This is a very important one.
He scored one, he's missed one, and this free has gone nicely over. So Noel McGrath makes it 1-4 to 5 points. As you say, back to a 2-point game again. Sean Finn over the head of Garrod Hagerty this time. Mulcahy then pushed in the back by Craig Morgan. An inexperienced player, Craig Morgan is 23, up against Graham Mulcahy, who's playing against Tipperary opponents in the championship for the 11th time. Man who's seen it all and done it all.
Yeah, I've liked the way he has come into the inter-county scene, and he's done very well, Craig Morgan. Interesting. Will have done a who out talking to the sideline here, so Tip probably are causing a bit of confusion, but they'll probably sort it out.
Here's Gallan to add to the goal and a point that he's already got from open play. Very, very satisfactory start for Aaron Gallan and for Limerick on the scoreboard. It's short, it's to Ronan Maher, and it's now up into the forwards to see what they can do, and it runs on and on. Goalkeeper Nicky Quaid comes out, prevents it from going on over the end line. Back down towards Kyle Hayes again, competing there with Ronan Maher. That's quite a duel, and it's Hayes who's got it. The man from Kildymo takes off, two men after him, he's on an advantage. It'll be a free in. He's going to take some marking. Giant of a man.
Yeah, nightmare stuff for Tip fans, because he gets it. Memories come flooding back of him running straight through the middle last year, and they weren't going to allow him get through there. And so Ronan Maher, I suppose, had given away the free. The ref was waiting to see how it would turn out, so it's good refereeing, really.
So after that good work by Kyle Hayes, it's Aaron Gallan to perform his party piece once again with 13 minutes gone. And no problems. 1-3 for Aaron Gallan. The youngsters, and maybe not so young fans of Limerick, are enjoying it enormously. Barry Hogan is in goal today. Brian was the goalkeeper for the last two matches. And that's out over the sideline here. Colin Bonner playing his part as well, the manager, urging his charges on to give that extra little bit. What do you make about the change of goalkeeper? Because I thought Brian Hogan did remarkably well in the last two games.
Yeah, you'd be wondering a bit about it. It must be something to do with distribution or something like that, Ger, because a couple of the saves he made against Clare that turned out to be goals and certainly weren't his fault were unusual to see a goalie drop in that situation.
Ronan Maher up and the wrong side of the post. So it's already five wides by Tipperary. He's the leadership. He's got to give that leadership, just 26 years of age. Nicky Quaid pucking it away out over there towards the far side, towards Tom Morrissey, but again won back by Tipperary. And over again towards Ger Brown. He's causing problems, feeding it carefully forward here. Casey breaks it down, able to get to it himself. Barry Nash leaves it there. Dan Morrissey running into traffic immediately. He's trying to get away out of difficulty, and the referee says he carried it too far. I'm sure Dan will say, what was I supposed to do?
Yeah, and is he being held? It's the big question. The two hands of Jack Morris, clever enough, gets the hands in and out, but it's certainly good work rate from Tipperary, we will say that. It's a referee's call. Steps is his decision. It's a free-in. It's another vital one for Tip.
Chance to make it a one-score game once again. Noel McGrath in his 61st championship game. Up and over, 3-3 with the freeze. Only one he's missed was from open play. Colin Bonner for the new Tipperary manager. It's been a trying time watching his side right now. Defend again. That's down towards Aaron Gallan. Over there with him went Cathal Barrett. And Barrett will be really fired up now after Gallan has got the early advantages on him and got the goal and a point from play already.
I think it's a line ball, Jared. I think Cathal Barrett was looking for a free, but I think it's just a line ball.
John Kiley watching on. A win here today would see Limerick into the Munster final with one match still to go. That game next Sunday in Ennis against Clare. Paddy Cadell involved. And then hefty challenge here. Tipperary player down, injured. Darragh O'Donovan walks away from that. This is what happened here. It was Craig Morgan came in. Challenge a bit high.
Yeah, a bit high. He was low and he was ducking down into it. But be interested to see what does Liam Gordon make of it. He didn't blow for anything initially.
Craig Morgan was one of those very fine young players at under 20 and under 21 level. He was captain of one of those years that resulted in a Tip win over Cork. There were two such wins. That's the goal again. My goodness.
You just can't get caught the wrong side of him, Jordan. You have to have him outside on those high ones. He's brilliant at last second just putting in his hand. You know, once he has it, then he's so tidy in the finish. And we're just going to have a throw in here, but looks things.
That seems to be the case. So an accidental collision, the referee has decided, and throw ball to start it all again. And winning it back there, Tipperary. Coming out with it is Dylan Quirk. Playing it forward here, Barry Heffernan. Keeping it moving outside there towards Paul Flynn. Haven't seen much of Paul Flynn so far in this game. Clearly got 2 points in the 2020 championship match here against Cork.
Free back, Jerry, he's decided, and Hagos, Gerard Hagerty's picking up a yellow card. He decided the advantage wasn't the croon, so Hago won't want to be picking up a yellow card that early in the game. And Tipper settling, you know, we would have thought maybe there was a bit of champagne hurling going on there. The crowd were all in almost, and Tip have settled in and are grinding hard here. Chance for Noel to bring it back to two. Limerick really haven't got motor, and I would say fully yet.
There's only that goal by Aaron Gillan after 8 minutes between the teams. From his own 65-metre line, Noel McGrath striking it up. Doing what he does very well. Taken over from Jason Ford with the free-taking. That's confirmation of the foul there a little while ago by Garrow Tegarty on Dylan Quirk. It resulted in the first yellow card of the match. Ball has been pucked out. Darrow Donovan picking it up here. Couldn't go to the left. Back inside again it comes towards Tom Morrissey. Hooked very well that time by Conor Snakenham, the third of Sarsfield's player. Good intensity required by Tipperary. They're stepping up to it. Declan Hannan steps into the breach here, picks up this one, fires it in. Is it going to carry the whole way in towards Gillan again? Looking to cause problems with Kyle Hayes. Defenders in there in number. It's still Gillan trying to chase after this one. Kyle Hayes also. Kyle Hayes with support players here. Tom Morrissey, and Morrissey looking to try and get something out of this attack, and they're going to get nothing out of it. It's their fourth wide instead.
Yeah, they're looking a little bit tip there. I mean, Carl Barrett was the wrong side of Gillan again, and he did get the hand to it, but he didn't hold on to it. And they forced Tom Morrissey to shoot under pressure.
That's a great puck out as far as Michael Breen. Chase now, and pursued by Will O'Donoghue. Comes out here. Barry Heffernan playing it back, this time to Gerard Brown. Brown has started the scoring, and he's got another one. Really good work. Well, as you mentioned, a goal at three when he came on as a second-half sub against Clare. 3 points already here. We'd only played 19 and a half minutes.
Yeah, credit to Barry Hogan. It was a fantastic puck out. Michael Breen finding... They're finding lots of pockets of space in the Limerick defence, and when they're composed like that and find their men, they're effective.
Graham Mulcahy has a spare man outside. It's Tom Morrissey feeding it forward. Garroyd Hagerty, and again, that's going to go the wrong side. Swept well away. Five wides by Limerick. They were playing the wonderful, flowing, attractive, marvellous hurling earlier on, but they're in a bit of difficulty in certain areas. And Dermot Burns, for instance, great free taker that he is, he's already allowed his man, Gerard Brown, to get 3 points from open play. There are issues to be addressed.
Yeah, and lads like Conor Stakelham going very well, you know, stuck in everything. Gerard Brown, as we said, Noel working very hard. Paddy Cadell effective at right half back. There's lots to like about the way they're going at the moment. Obviously, you have to keep that up for a long, long time against Limerick.
They've got a sideline cut coming up here. That'll be Dylan Quirk standing over it, the Clonalty player. Beautifully over, broken down, but to Tom Morrissey, and then he lost it. Noel McGrath steps in, tries to get away from trouble, blocked out that time by Dan Morrissey, and back to help once again. And get it away out of danger as Scott O'Neill. It's in the possession of Darrow Donovan. All the way down along to Graham Mulcahy. Caught him with that left hand. Got out ahead of his man. Beat the attempted block. But missed with the final effort. And it remains 1-6 to 8 points. Just a 1 point game.
Yeah, much better by Craig Morgan there. He didn't dive in and force the shot under pressure.
Gerard Brown again. Got it from the puck out. Didn't like it from the time he left it off his stick. Six wides.
There's no doubt there, they're getting no handle on Gerard Brown at all. I mean, in fairness to Burns, he's not marking him at the moment. He's a spare man right on the halfway line, if you like. I don't know who's meant to be picking him up, but there isn't anybody at the minute.
Limerick's puck out. caught well by Dylan Quirk. Away by Craig Morgan. They're playing some of the best hurling they've played in this year's championship right now. They're taking it up to the All-Ireland champions. It's Mark Keogh. It's over here as far as Paul Flynn. Paul Flynn blocked down. Comes again. Noel McGrath with the resultant final effort. And it sneaks inside the left-hand upright and goes over the bar. And Noel McGrath's got five. And the teams are level.
Yeah, Noel punches the air there to rise up. There isn't a massive tip crowd here, but what's here is making plenty noise at the moment. Great catch by Dylan Quirk. That started it all. Got it up to Paul Flynn. He probably should have passed it the first time. Got a second chance, found Noel. And he nails it as he normally would.
31-year-old Noel McGrath puts the teams level for the third time in Limerick. Garroid Hagerty trying to advance. Back, Will O'Donoghue. Didn't hit it terribly cleanly and didn't hit it terribly well either.
But they do get off an awful lot of shots, and we always talk about that in analysis, Gerard, but the accuracy is very poor at the moment.
Craig Morgan under pressure from Gillan. Then the next challenge comes in there. It's from Darrow Donovan. Referee decides it's an unfair challenge. It's going to be a free to Tipperary. They'll be very, very pleased with their opening 23 minutes work.
Yeah, it's that spare arm on his arm. I think that's why he gave the free. It's Aaron Gillan. Darrow Donovan, maybe he had a go as well. So I think he had pointed down the field, though, that he was fouled initially. And that's good refereeing, really, I think, because there was an arm holding back his catching hand, if you like.
Barry Hogan taking this one and driving it to the left. Well, of course, it's their first meeting since last year's Munster final. Tipperary scored 3 goals in 21 in that. They were 10 points up at halftime. They lost by 4 to Limerick. Noel McGrath was there that day. Carried in here, Jake Morris. And that's gone over the bar. Beautifully done by Jake Morris. He scored 1-2 in last year's final. I was just mentioning there. Dylan Quirk got the touch to it. That was Conor Stakelham somehow getting it off the ground. And then the final effort by Morris. Limerick haven't scored now since the 14th minute. So it's 10 minutes since they've troubled the scoreboard operator.
Yeah, and he's given a free against Dylan Quirk that time. Maybe he's coming into the back of the Limerick player, but he did superbly for the previous two deliveries that he contested, but maybe he just was slightly more into the back of Tom Morrissey in that occasion. And Liam Gordon right on the spot decides a free, and Limerick could badly do with a score.
David Byrne's going to take it. No longer picking up Ger Brown. He started on Brown all right. Burns hitting it, looking to level it up again. It's not quite working just at the moment. They have 7 wides. Tipperary have 8. Quick puck out. Casey trying to go up for it there with Morrissey. Comes down to a Tipperary player. That Tipperary player was Jake Morris. In it comes here to Barry Heffernan. Barry Heffernan feeding it forward to Breed. Saved well by Nicky Quaid. Breen, who scored goals in the past here. That should have been another one. Barry Nash held up there by Noel McGrath. It's going to be a free out for Limerick, and they'll be mighty relieved.
Yeah, it was great work by Tip. They were very patient on the ball. Beautiful ball inside to Barry Heffernan. Oh, Michael Breen will be disappointed. Barry Nash did well to put him under pressure. He was afraid of the hooks, likely, and maybe he hit it too far in front of himself, but you won't beat Nicky Quaid. From that angle, he's as brave as a lion and covered the angles well, and you'd have to go low to the far corner to beat him in that situation, Joe.
Barry Nash pucking it away quickly. Racing in after it there is Graham Mulcahy, trying to get the better of Craig Morgan. Aaron Gillan, Limerick, and Gillan haven't scored for a while. Looking to try and put that right. Underhits this one. Barry Hogan hand-passing it back out to the security of Seamus Kennedy, pursued by Kyle Hayes, away by Craig Morgan, up into the air to collect. This one goes Dermot Burns, over into open space, Darrow Donovan. Donovan feeds it forward. There are two Limerick players there. Hannon's one of them. Back out again it comes to Dermot Burns. Took a look at the post. Gives it back instead to Darrow Donovan, tried to break forward, pursued by Tipperary men who are closing in the whole time and making life very awkward for Limerick. untypical of the champions.
Yeah, and massive work by Tip Dodder. They're allowing them maybe to win it in the half-back line, but they're saying no further than this, or you go along. So Michael Breen just got his whole lead to that first before the Limerick man got his to it, so it's like a chop and a bit of action going on off the ball as well here, Joe.
Certainly is that. Referee making his way back down along to try and sort this one out with Sean Stack, his linesman.
I don't know if too much happened there, but Sean Stack certainly was right on the spot anyway. And he'll have seen everything that happened if anything did happen.
Let's go down to the sideline for a moment here, get a word from Damien Lawler, our reporter. Damien.
Chair, no major panic on the Limerick sideline with the amount of wides that they've hit, but they're struggling to pick up Gerard Brown. Everybody's had a go at marking him, from Colin O'Neill to Dan Morrissey to Dara Donovan, but Brown is drifting into space the whole time. As regards Tipperary, they're just completely pumped up in the sideline with the increasing amount of turnovers and work rate that their defence is putting forward. So Tipperary delighted with that, but the Limerick puck out, the options are massive, and Tipperary management are keen to crack down on that.
Thank you, Damien. Right, play will continue with a free for Noel McGrath and Tipperary. As you can see, they're a point up with 7 minutes to go to half-time. Perfect again by Noel McGrath. He's now on 6 points for the match.
It turned a big concern for John Kiley. I said, no panic, Damien told us, but they haven't scored in 14 or 15 minutes, so... he'll be anxious to get one now, and here's the chance.
And it's Cathal O'Neill, the youngster, and Cathal O'Neill who responds positively and puts it over the bar. Just his sixth ever point in the championship. He's done well in the last two games.
Yeah, it's a good score, great catch. And was dragged back by Paddy Cadell, and he missed a couple early on, but he'll keep shooting. He's a confident young fella. They needed that one.
First score for Limerick in 15 minutes. Ger Brown up into the air, drops it. Declan Hannan stands ashore there, but is under a lot of pressure. After an uncertain start, Tipperary have got into it with ferocious intensity, but they can't quite finish that move with a score by Michael Breen on a ground where he got 2-1 back in 2016. 8 wides by Tipperary.
Yeah, he'll be disappointed again, Ger. That's 1-1 now. That maybe, you know, he'd like to be thinking that was an easy chance to goal. Maybe it was a bit more tough.
Well, who got the last touch there? The linesman over there, Sean Stack, happy that it was the Tipperary defender. So line ball to Limerick coming up. An afternoon for fans here to relish. Limerick, the champions, going for a fourth title this year in Munster. And this is their last home game, of course, as well. John Kiley in pensive mood.
Don't know what the delay is for here, Ger. It's just maybe a slitter waiting to come
just
out. Just
waiting for a ball to be thrown back out now. Are we stuck with yellow slitters forever, by the way?
I know, yeah. I find it in the middle of the day anyway. There's no problem on why should I be using them. But there's another example. They're just slightly off, Ger. There's no doubt about it. Is it listening to everything they've listened to all week that this would be easy for them, and Tip had very little to play for, this sort of thing? But Tip haven't read the script, and they're coming here full of determination. I think this Ger Brown situation is typifying. They've no handle on him at the moment, and a lot of Tip supporters out there will be saying, where was he for the last couple of years?
Dylan Quirk hitting this one in towards that inside forward line. I saw a jersey pull there. The referee ignores it and lets play continue, and Limerick get it away out to the absolutely totally unmarked Cathal O'Neill. They're late to get to him. O'Neill got the last one, and he has doubled his money.
Yeah, just space, and Paddy Cadell got sucked up the field with Hegarty, and O'Neill drifted across, and Seamus Kennedy didn't maybe move across to meet him. Instead, he went back as a sort of a sweeper role, and O'Neill will score lots of those if he gets the chances. Here goes Brown again.
Yeah, teams level four times. Brown trying to feed it forward for Noel McGrath. Then he has to go back here because there are two Limerick players in hot pursuit. Barry Heffernan against... strides forward, looks up at the target. That's a beauty by Heffernan. Man who got that very peculiar goal in the match against Clare. They'll all count, I know he'll say, but that's a very valuable point. Tipper back in front again.
Yeah, and Barry is someone that Liam Sheedy would have always trusted to shoot, and shows there that he can play anywhere, really.
Paddy Cadell can't hold on to it, supported here by Seamus Kennedy. This is Conor Stakenham. It's a mix of players with experience and players who are very new to this kind of competition. Stakenham growing in maturity the whole time.
Yeah, he's done very well, Gerard. He'll be delighted with his first half. So will Colin Bonner, and you know, going into the tackle and taking on the tough ball. And like always, Limerick have that reputation that they'll be very hard to get through, but they're having a go.
Noel McGrath to put Tip 2 in front, close to half time. 7 for McGrath. 11th time that he is facing Tip in the championship, or in Limerick in the championship rather, and he's won 5 of the previous matches. Again, it is Cathal O'Neill who comes to gather into Graham Mulcahy. Mulcahy strikes with power and accuracy, and that's his first.
Yeah, and O'Neill has gone into the middle now. Hegarty was playing a lot in the middle, and O'Neill has gone into the middle now, and I think that's suiting him better. He's getting first to the puck outs. Good ball up. Graham Mulcahy has been sharp so far, has shown in front, had a wide, got fouled for one already. Now, from a concerning point of view, he's down holding his leg, so just the way he landed maybe there didn't look the most comfortable. So from a Limerick point of view, they'll be hoping he's okay. He's looked sharp.
Looking at the way it's gone so far, Anthony, where Tipperary is concerned, they've done very well with the freeze. Noel McGrath getting them. Gerb Brown started really well. Those 3 points. Just 1 point for the players in the inside forward line. Morris has got one. Mark Keogh's got one. And there's a yellow card now for Craig Morgan. By comparison, Aaron Gillan got a goal and 2 earlier on, and then a couple of frees. Graham Mulcahy only 1. Not a lot, an awful lot happening in the last 10, 15 minutes in that inside forward line.
No, and Limerick are still, I suppose, doing well around the middle. There's a lot of loose play, but you see that ball up there, isn't it? You know, that's a tough ball to take. Now, whatever chance you have, your Mark Keogh, you've got to put your hand on that. So, but there isn't too much ball going into the inside line, but they'd be quite happy to work it at that. Yeah, it's a late one. It's the one no one likes, really, is the block down on the hands, and deservedly gets a yellow card for that, Craig Morgan.
Yellow card per team. Late on in this first half, then, it's Barry Nash. Oof, not a great ball to give to Cathal O'Neill. There were so many Tipperary players there. Barry Heffernan trying to pick this one up. Challenge there by O'Neill again. Stalemate situation. Eventually, Darragh O'Donovan comes out with it. Played away by Limerick, but again, collecting it is Ronan Maher. Given to Conor Stakenham, and Stakenham hits it, but the ball, he was on an advantage, so it's got to be a free to Tipperary. Stakenham shot had gone wide, but he was on a free shot, as it were. Tip making a change. Paddy Cadell is going off, and the player who's going on is Robert Byrne.
Yeah, I don't know if there was a knock or something. Maybe the last few minutes they've struggled with their man-on-mans, but...
So Paddy Cadell goes off. That was his first time to play in this year's championship, and it has lasted nearly 35 minutes. Robert Byrne did come on as a blood sub in the game against Waterford. 2 minutes of additional time will be added. Noel McGrath again to add to the 7 that he's already got here. It's now 8. And Tip fans probably now wondering, is it on? Could they win here? Or is it going to be a repeat of what happened in last year's Munster final in Cork, when Limerick simply took over in the second half and won well in the end? That's a good ball across towards Will O'Donoghue. And O'Donoghue's shot is poor. He had plenty of time. Nobody on him.
Yeah, the amount of those they've missed is incredible at this stage. I know they're just easy ones by their own standards. And Cathal O'Neill is having a growing influence on the game, though. He's getting on ball and being able to lift his head, and that's dangerous for Colin Bonner. They need to address that.
Barry Heffernan almost got caught for overholding, had to let it drop. Comes out here. Man who's taking this chance is Jake Morris. And Jake has pulled it, and pulled it poorly. A lot of wides between the two teams. Between them, they've had 18 wides in the first half, 9 each.
Yeah, that was a shot probably that should have gone up the line. Robert Byrne had overlapped, and...
Well, this is Cathal O'Neill. He's already scored 2 points in the match. And you can see the concern there, John Kiley and Paul Kinnerk. They don't want to lose him. He's up on his feet again quickly. Thankfully, he'll be able to continue. Awful shame he can't play in that under 20 final, isn't it?
All round, Jerry. I've made my views fairly clear on that. It's a terrible rule.
Declan Hannan firing it down. Tom Morrissey adding to it. Coming out is Gillan. All his good early scoring was much earlier on. He's going again, plays it out here, out as far as Tom Morrissey, blocked down. Another opportunity for Morrissey. Half hit, bit of a hook as well. Credit Tipperary for the way in which they have settled down after an uncertain open 10 minutes. They have been the better team. That's not the greatest. Straight to Dan Morrissey this time. Into Kyle Hayes. Flicked out as far as Darrow Donovan. Taking it around one, now two, getting into a third, and then the hand pass is an illegal one. Hurley was dropped anyway.
I'm not certain, Gerard. Did he indicate that he dropped a Hurley or he caught it three times? He dropped a Hurley, I think, the hand pass at, was it being held? We can have a look here. No, he dropped a Hurley, yeah, you just can't do that. And surprises are making that mistake. Probably well, so conscious.
Just watch this.
That's Gerard Brown again, I think, over the far side, was it? Gerard Brown has been absolutely everywhere.
So heading into the final few seconds of this first half, Anthony, I think Tipperary will be greatly encouraged.
They'll be delighted, and this will be a huge one now. If Ronan Maher was to nail this, it's a long, long way back. He'd probably have it in his locker, all right, if he tries it.
This is the second long-range one that he's had a go at, and another one has been missed. But there's the half-time whistle here, and it is Tipperary, very, very much the outsiders, with Ger Brown scoring 3 points in that first half. Aaron Gillan got a goal and three, a goal and a point from open play. John Kiley with a bit of thinking and a bit of talking to do to his charges. The teams go into their respective dressing rooms. It's Tipperary who lead at the break by 2 points in this Munster round-robin match. Coming to you from Limerick, it's Limerick 1-9. Tipperary 14 points. We're back with Joanne and the panel right after this.
So we're still awaiting the teams to come back onto the pitch for the second half. Tipperary leading Limerick by 2 points, remember, 1-9 to 14 points. We've spoken about how good Tipperary were. Let's talk about how not so good Limerick were.
Yeah, you get the feeling that, you know, in some of Limerick's play in the first half, you know, has that the bit of complacency set in, you know. Graham Mulcahy, you know, normally he'd step inside and make no mistake there, you know, it goes wide. But it seems to be a trend, you know. I've stood up here a lot of times and applauded him for the way they play. But definitely today, some of their finishing has not been of the levels that they generally expect of themselves, and ultimately has been poor, and they've looked at a little bit of sloppiness, and I think some of that is creeping into their play, and it's not just in some of these that we're showing in terms of the striking. Even sometimes distribution of the ball has been very, very poor. You know, look, like Will O'Donoghue, like in fairness, Carl O'Neill picks him out really, really well. You know, for him that's just routine point. I'd nearly turned away. So I think for Limerick, they're going to have a really, really strong chat and say, like, they're not at the pitch of where they've been for the last 2 days. But now, full credit to Tipperary. You know, Tipperary deserve a lot of credit because they've really brought the challenge to them. But Limerick haven't had the answers in that first half. So it's going to be a big 35
minutes. And what they're doing as well, Liam, is Tipperary, they're pushing up. They're squeezing on the Limerick half-forward midfielder. So when Limerick are trying to work their way out from the full back line, they have to try hit long ball because they can't play it out. And I know then we said, OK, they leave a bit of space inside. But so far, it's worked for Tipperary.
Yeah, it has. And I think the key thing now is that they don't have a situation where if they push so far up that they get sucked into a really deep position up front and leave an open space here, because if Limerick gets space here in the second half, they will exploit it. So to be trying to keep that half back line connected to their inside back line will be important for Tip.
You were the man in the dressing room in last year's Munster final when your team was 10 points up. What went wrong there that you think can be avoided today?
Well, I think the half back line got pulled out the field and they followed and they went very, very deep. So Limerick moved their positioned their half back line much closer and they moved everything back closer to their own goals, and then they won the ball there, worked it out and pushed it in front of us. So, you know, I think Tip hopefully will have learned from that. So hopefully, you know, we can get that right in the second half, because I certainly didn't get it right last year.
Can they hang on?
That's a big ask. But listen, you know, they've given themselves a really good chance here. They're in a position where they can have a right go the second half.
You worry, Shane?
I would trust John and Paul to get things right inside there. Joanne, I think they haven't played well, but I think, you know, throughout the last couple of years, they've been in these positions before. They were in this position last year. They're only, 2 points behind now. They were 10 behind last year. I have full faith in Limerick to come out. But I do think if Tipperary can keep up what they're doing, it should make for a very, very close finish.
It is. Well, the crowd are trying to get behind them anyway. Oh, well, it wasn't a good day for Mr. Van Graan yesterday, but will it be a good day for the people of Limerick today? So far, it's going Tip's way. Back to Anthony and Ger.
Yeah, two between them as Limerick come out. Bit of work to do, most definitely. It's their 74th, in fact, championship meeting. In the previous 73, Tip have been victorious on 36 occasions. Limerick with 27 wins. Tip wanting a victory here. They've one more match to go after this in the round robin. They will be at home to Cork in 2 weeks' time. And if they bow out of the Munster Championship, it's a long, long time until we see a Limerick or a Tipperary inter-county team in action again at this level. Tip with the first possession, started the second half. Ger Brown, two men go to him immediately. He almost came up with it. A third man from Limerick came in to try and pinch it away from him. Eventually, it's Carl O'Neill, who has had some very, very good moments. Garrod Hagerty is down, injured at the present time. And the referee saw a throw ball there. So it's got to be a Tipperary free in front of an attendance today of 27,141. Well, that's a concern immediately. Garrod Hagerty is not the kind of guy who lies down on the ground for too long if he really has sustained an injury. And having lost Kian Lynch, they would be concerned. He's up on his feet again, thankfully. As Noel McGrath gets the opening point of the second half, they got the first point at the start of the match as well. So now they go three in front. Nicky Quaid looking to try and get that Limerick forward line moving. Mulcahy played it back, but only as far as Noel McGrath. Once he rolled it up, three Limerick players converged on him. And it breaks loose here as far as Tom Morrissey. And he looks to reply, but misses. 10 wides by Limerick this afternoon. Not what you expect.
Noel McGrath didn't control that one first time, and they absolutely surrounded him and forced him back, but didn't convert the score then when they turned it over.
Paul Flynn getting that ball back. It was intended there for Robert Byrne, who came in as a late sub before the end of the first half. And again, Hagerty goes down, injured. Limerick will have themselves a free and a chance for them to get the first score for Limerick for the second half.
Yeah, tidy.
Oof, there was a boot there. The boot of Robert Byrne ended up on Garrod Hagerty's back. I don't think it was intentional. Very, very accidental, I think. Gillan ready to take this. He got a goal and three. All of that in the first 15 minutes, and now that is a good start for him for the second half. And Limerick fans will be hoping now it's the first of many Limerick scores, and business as usual by the champions. Barry Hogan going long with this one, but he's pucked it straight out to Cathal O'Neill. Now Limerick's turn to come in to try and win. And they do with Aaron Gillan. And Gillan is suddenly in the clear. Noel McGrath's after him. Gillan, the ball wasn't coming up very well for him. And in the end, he mishits this one. On another day and another sod, if the ball had bounced kindly for him, he'd have been in for a score.
Yeah, you don't expect that with him. And again, Cathal O'Neill kind of intercepted the puck out and didn't make it stick. And then Aaron kind of overplayed that, if anything. Maybe half thinking of opening up for a goal, but a complete mishit at the end of it.
Barry Hogan's puck out over the head there of Dermot Burns, and it's Tipperary who advance with this one. Paul Flynn, into the hands of goalkeeper Nicky Quaid. Feeds it back out towards Barry Nash. Sean Finn. They're playing it among themselves, the full back line, under a lot of pressure. Mike Casey manages to get it out to the recovered Garrod Hagerty. fires it into the corner here. Gillan drifts out. Two Tipperary men going after him. It's Gillan. He's still got it. They roar him on and he takes too many steps. And that degree of uncertainty is rewarded with a Tipperary free out. And as you can see, Colm Bonner absolutely delighted with the efforts of his defenders.
Yeah, the argument there, Dodger, is that did Cathal Barrett foul him? I think you would say he did. It seemed to be, you know, he didn't connect at the wall and he kind of chopped across. But wasn't much force in it now or anything like that. But I would have thought it was a free first and big roar for Shane Flanagan entering the fray.
Who comes in for the inexperienced Cathal O'Neill, who had some great moments in the first half, but they need the senior men in. They're not going to take any chances. It's a match Limerick want to win. Victory would see them into the Munster final in a few weeks' time. Barry Nash has time, has space, and picks out Garrod Hegarty. Nobody was running with him in a Tipperary jersey. And Garrod Hegarty is able to knock it in and over the bar. That was all too easy.
Yeah, just so much more like it, Jaron. He made the dart across in the middle, and he loves that pocket of space over here on the right-hand side, and following on from the huge roar of Shamie Flanagan entering the fray. Massive one to follow it, and the Limerick crowd really know their team are under a bit of pressure here, so they're getting right up behind them.
It's a one-point game. Nash again going down in difficulty. Tip have it back. Breen feeds it for Noel McGrath. Very awkward angle this time confronting him. He's put the ball wide. It's their first wide of the second half, and they're 11th in all in this contest.
Yeah, Munster still have nearly been chalking down here on the sideline because Noel has been flawless from any shot he's taken. So disappointed with that one.
Nicky Quaid with a big, big long one down towards Garrod Hegarty. From the puck out, they have those big men, Kyle Hayes, Garrod Hegarty to aim at. But it's a Tipperary man who emerges with it or tries to do so in Dylan Quirk. A ferocious battle for possession here. Graham Mulcahy was nipping in. Colm Bonner was on the sideline saying, come on, it's our ball. And in the end, the linesman down there, Sean Stack, says yes. Tip ball. So that's word we're getting from the sideline now that Cathal O'Neill was withdrawn because of an ankle injury. They put ice on it immediately, not too serious, and he's been replaced by Seamus Flanagan. And this is what followed immediately after that, sheer intensity.
Yeah, savage stuff, Jaron. Colm Bonner right onside it, and he's absolutely driving them on. We speculated about what's going on in the Limerick dressing room at halftime. Obviously, Bonner has given it pell-mell, as they say, in there to drive on his lads, playing for pride. Craig Morgan looks like he has an ankle injury, so they'll be hoping this isn't, because he's played well.
You were saying it on the RT podcast, in fact, on Thursday. Tipperary players, they are very proud of their tradition, their heritage. They weren't going to come here and just lie down.
No, I kind of felt all the week that the narrative was probably too one-sided. I mean, Tip traditionally would always have being able to put it up to Limerick, it'd be 50-50 with them, but there was too much talk of a complete write-off, I think.
That's brilliantly caught. Nicely done. Onto it goes great Jake Morris, and Morris flicks it over the bar. Having been fed the pass by Connor Stakenham, it's Jake Morris's second, and another for Tipperary.
At risk of saying it, it was just a good old-fashioned line ball. We don't see them too often. Great work by Stakenham, won his own ball. Spotted his buddy from Nina outside him and gave it up to him.
2-point game again, Tip in front. That's Roland Maher driving it forward. Limerick have the numbers there. They have possession as well. It's Barry Nash flicking it back outside toward Dermot Burns. All the way down along the line to Gillan, dropped it. Cathal Barrett gleefully went back, bent his knee, got into it, tigerishly tries to take it out, struggling to hold on to it and get it away quickly before he fouls the ball. Helped out here. Craig Morgan is in the thick of it. So too is the Tipperary manager. Playing every ball that's loose down there is Colm Bonner.
Yeah, it's the fine lines of whether it's an overcarry or a foul. I don't know. It's very hard to tell what's what. He's arguing, I think, that it's the free hand that's been dragged. I don't know. It's very inconclusive from that.
Gesticulating brilliantly down there, as always, Colm Bonner. Free at the end of it all to Tipperary, and Noel McGrath, that's his angle. He's already got 9 points in this match, two of them from open play. This one is moving away right, tried to keep it in, they do so. It was the full forward who had a go at that. In the end, it's Paul Flynn to follow up the work of Mark Yeo and to put it over the bar. That's the first point of the match for Paul Flynn, down there where he got a couple of points against Cork in the 2020 Munster Championship. So it's 111 to 17 points.
Half chance for Mark Yeo. Great block by Mike Casey. Flynn does the right thing then. Takes his point.
Darrow Donovan hitting it and up over the crossbar. A point in each half for a player playing in his 26th ever championship match. And it's 112 to 17 points. Once again, it's a two-point game.
Yeah, it's much better than the first half to really overall. The intensity is up. The crowd are more up. Both sides going really hard at it.
Mike Casey trying to come across and take that one. And in the end, it was Flynn who got the stick to it. And it went agonisingly across the wrong side of the Goalmouth area. And Limerick got away with that.
Two let-offs for Limerick there. That was lucky as well. Just a level of indecisiveness back there that we haven't really seen in a couple of years. And two let-offs really for goal chances. Flynn did very well to get the flick just wrong side of the post.
Tipperary preparing Conor Bowe as well from Moyne Timpletuhi. He played in the match against Waterford, got injured. Tip have it again. Noel McGrath under pressure there from Darrow Donovan. Got it forward. Now it's Ronan Maher. Has to go again, but this time Seamus Flanagan nips in. Can't keep it in possession for Limerick, however, because it's won back again by Tipperary. And then Garrod Hegarty comes, takes, drives forward. How do you stop this man? Forward as far as Tom Morrissey. And Morrissey strikes, and strikes superbly. Adding to the point he got earlier on in the game, Tom Morrissey has made it 113 to 17 points, one between them.
Yeah, Hegarty was definitely fouled, and Liam Gordon had pointed for that, and Conor Stakelam gets a yellow. I thought it was Noel McGrath that fouled, actually, to be honest, but there was a foul. But they'd be delighted to see Morrissey getting the score from play. They'd prefer that for momentum, for his own confidence as well.
So Conor Stakelam booked, 11 minutes are gone in the second half. Thankfully, there's loads and loads left in this game. That's broken down by Mark Yeo. Two or three Limerick players go after him. He's still got it. Barry Nash trying to get in a challenge. Yeo looking for a support player. It was Flynn who came in. Limerick get it back. It's Sean Finn. Finn soloing, then challenge. The challenge from Conor Stakelam. Out over the sideline went the Limerick number two. Brilliant work by Stakelam. Timed it perfectly.
Yeah, he's not afraid to have a go anyway. The argument being there, Ger, had Finn played the ball when he was tackled. Some will argue, I think that Limerick crowd behind it, the incident, are incensed. But young Stakelam certainly putting himself about anyway, just after picking up a yellow. Wrongly, in my opinion, now, I don't think he was the man that deserved the yellow.
Noel McGrath's ready to hit this one. On freeze, on sidelines. It's travelling through the air. It's flying up and over the bar. 10 points. A combination of freeze from play and now a sideline from Noel McGrath.
Yeah, fantastic skill from Noel. He's been immense all day, and a huge lift again for the, as I said, the few that have travelled from Tip. It's a sea of green and white in front of us, but scores like that are massive. And Conor Bono coming in to replace, I think, Paul Flynn is coming.
Paul Flynn, having scored a championship point, comes off, and on comes Conor Bono. So an opportunity for the manager to freshen up his team. Energy, a lot of energy will be needed to taking on the reigning Munster and All-Ireland champions. Mike Casey gets it out as far as Declan Hannan. Nicely forward, carried on by Darrow Donovan. Feeds it in towards Seamus Flanagan. Runs loose. Craig Morgan back there, nonchalantly almost picking it up. Goalkeeper Barry Hogan. On to another Barry Heffernan. Slipped there, a miss by Seamus Kennedy. Should have been able to pick it up immediately. In the end, it's kicked out off the boot of Garrod Hegarty, and Tipper fortunate to hold possession.
Yeah, he's played well, Seamus Kennedy, but just a bit sloppy there. He's lucky that they retained the puck out, because Hegarty was over for the turnover very quick.
It'll be Ronan Maher who will take this. All the times he's played against Limerick in the past, he's been playing alongside his brother Porrick, who's now retired from this level of the game. That's a great catch, under pressure there, superbly done, but given away, and given away to Jake Morris, and Morris penalises the error. I think it was Dermot Burns who gave it away to him, and that's three that he's now managed to get.
Yeah, that just probably sums it up so far, Gerard. They've just been off it a bit. Burns to Finn is one we see all the time, sticking, and poor pass, poor miscommunication, and tip punish.
Well, Limerick still have lots and lots of time left in which to rescue this match and get the win they need and take them through to the Munster final with a game still to go. But Tip of other ideas, and taking it up here is Conor Bowe. And Conor Bowe was on an advantage, and the ball's going to be brought back. He's making a difference. He's got to add legs and energy and all the rest of it. Real dashing wing forward, Conor Bowe. Made his championship debut in the football with the Tip footballers against Kerry last year. Mention of other sports. The Clare Camogie team did very well, Anthony, in the Munster final. Or is it the
semi-final? Intermead Cork in the Munster final. A great win for great work going on in the background in Clare Camogie. It was a huge win.
Noel McGrath looking to add to the 10 he got. And that's one that's gone wide of the target.
And to be severe, Ninja, to say this one that got away, but because he's been so good. But they can do with him all, I think, at this stage.
There's a good 20 minutes still to go here. Ger Brown, unchallenged as he's hitting it, and he has missed two bad misses in a row by Tipperary.
Yeah, Jake Morris incensed up ahead of Ninja. He was in acres of space, and he's given out to him to give it up to me if you're in that situation again.
Inside towards Aaron Gallan, somehow grabbed it, held on to it, feeds it back out to Graham Mulcahy, gives it to Seamus Flanagan, steadies himself, must score, but he doesn't. He's missed it. There's a flat appearance about Limerick today, which is not usual, not what we expect.
No, and it was out of the sideline, but you'd expect he'd enough time to get his radar, you know, bang on there, but way wide, like it was well outside the post.
Barry Hogan's drive downfield from that puck out. Conor Bowe going across, taking it up, slipping it over his left shoulder. Missed opportunity. That's gone up to 15, I think, now.
Yeah, that's three in a row from their point of view as well. And he seems to have added a good bit of legs, Dodger. He's lively and he's getting on the board straight away as he come on.
19 scores by Tipperary and 15 wides into the bargain. That's a lot of shooting. Garrett Hagerty looks up, sees in space Kyle Hayes. Is he going to get another one? Not if Tipperary have their way. They came across, they put him off, and the chance is gone.
Yeah, outstanding work by Dylan Quirk. Look at the pace he showed. Hayes bearing down on goal. At the same time, Kyle Barrow was coming across to meet him like last year. But that's a big lift to the Tipperary crowd.
Sure is. He scored goals last year in that Munster final, scored one this year, of course, against Cork, Kyle Hayes. Nothing so far today, but they come again. And now it's Barry Nash, who has scored 10 points in the championship in the past. When he plays in the forwards, he's showing them how it's done. His first. Little between the teams, it's back to a two-point game again.
Yeah, what a score. Darrow Donovan picked up a heavy knock in the move, but Nash all pace, all overlapping, given that freedom to go forward. We haven't seen much of it today, as we have in the previous two games, but a huge buzz around the place now. You know, 18, 19 minutes, whatever injury time to go, and Limerick being asked the hard questions, they usually come up with the answers. Can they do it again today?
Well, they'll be wondering if it's a shade like yesterday's football match in Munster, where Cork and Kerry were neck and neck after 50 to 55 minutes, and then the favourites prevailed, and prevailed well, in the last quarter of an hour to 15 minutes, quarter of an hour to 20 minutes. Will the same happen here? And will Limerick come good? Dropped out that time by Declan Hannan. Immediately onto it came Conor Stakenham. Under pressure there from Mike Casey. Out over the sideline, and the line ball is going Limerick's way. They're in a battle, that's for sure.
Oh, it's a huge battle out there now. Tip, you know, I think if he has one or two more, he's short a lot of players that he'd like to throw in there at the moment, but what he has thrown in has been fresh legs, and you saw the speed shown by Dylan Kirk going backwards there to get the hook. Fantastic work by him.
David Reedy has got to come on. And the player who's making way is going to be Darragh O'Donovan. Limerick have those options. You look through their subs bench, there's quite a few there.
There might be changing who's coming off.
Yeah, it is.
It's William O'Donoghue instead, I'd say.
Yeah, that's the difficulty, you see. The programme has got the numbers in the other order.
Yep.
William O'Donoghue is down as 8, but he's wearing 9. So a reprieve for Darragh O'Donovan. Limerick back into the attack again. Tom Morrissey thought about going and having a go. Slipped it back in. First touch for Reedy. Out to Morrissey again. Stayed on his feet. Tricky angle. Not for Tom Morrissey. That's his third. He really is excelling out there. And now it's a one-point game. And the Limerick fans all around in a crowd in excess of 27,000 feel the victory will be on. But will it? Out over the sideline, went off the boot there of Mark Keogh in the end.
The tip crowd suggesting that it was off Sean Finn. But everyone is roaring for everything at the moment now. Both managers claiming everything. That was a great score by Tom Morrissey off the left.
In terms of the frees awarded so far, there have been 20, and Tipperary have been awarded 14 of those. Dermot Burns trying to get it back towards Darragh O'Donovan. Sean Finn now trying to get there ahead of Noel McGrath, succeeding back out as far as Declan Hannan. Hannan then from deep inside his own half all the way down towards Aaron Gillard, battling with Cathal Barrett. Gillard goes again and used the hurley somewhat indiscriminately across Ronan Maher, and he could be in difficulty. So let's have a look at this again in a moment. He went in hard for the challenge there, Aaron Gillan.
Yeah, definitely late. Jar, was he committed to the pull? Did he half pull out? But Ronan Maher gets a slap all right. He's frustrated. Himself and Barrett are having a tough battle. A lot of Limerick people here. The free count is I think it's 15-6 now to tip. So they are a bit frustrated in the crowd that they're not getting enough fair play. And Liam Gordon decides it's a yellow. I honestly think that probably was no more than that.
So yellow for Aaron Gillan. And Ronan Maher will pick himself off the ground after all of that and get on with it. Well, he's giving the leadership for this team and has to do so in a side missing so many familiar figures from recent years. Two hard battlers, both of them. Been through it all so many times in the past. Craig Morgan also getting a little rub here.
And Tip rightly, from their point of view, slowing everything down for the moment and just, you know, taking the sting out of it and allowing themselves to fill the lungs for the last quarter battle, which is, it's going to be tough going down long now with the last 13 plus whatever's added on.
There'll be another Limerick sub on in a moment here. It'll be Connor Boylan who'll come in next. Played in the last match. Darragh O'Donovan now the receiving end, and he's got a yellow card also. Well, but for the mix-up in the numbers, he could have been off by now. But he's out there getting a yellow, ready to continue do his stuff as he always does. Change coming up. It'll be Graham Mulcahy who will make way. Connor Boylan comes on. Mulcahy of Kilmallock replaced. Pressure on the Limerick goal again. It bounces around in there. Mark Keogh trying to keep it in play. Conor Bow likewise. And the end of it all, the umpire's walked across. Is it gone out for a 65?
I don't think he's too sure, Jar. He'd surely have signalled at this stage. It's been given now and there.
Yeah, it is now.
And Tip seem to be getting a lot of the breaks. A lot of the 50-50 calls are going their way. So days like that, you have to make hay it's a great contest, Joe, and a lot of people were telling us that the Munster Championship was kind of done and dusted. Coming into today, we knew the three, and Tip saying definitely that that's not it, not the case, and that wasn't on their minds coming here.
I think it went off Sean Finn's leg at the, right at the end there. I think it did. I think it's the correct call. Noel McGrath taking this, and he's now on 11 points for the match. The last point he got was from the sideline, so his 65s, freeze, play, you name it, and there are two between them, and there you have it, 11 minutes of the 70, still to go. Kyle Hayes comes out to try and win this tuck out for Limerick, didn't get it, not the first time, but he has it now. And then there was a foul on him, and you wonder why the play just didn't continue.
Yeah, Noel McGrath, he's a bit lucky now because Conor Stakelam got a yellow a few minutes ago and I thought maybe he should have got, but sometimes there's a yellow given, Ger, when the player's called back, I think, a bit too easily.
If you're a Limerick fan, you wanted the referee to continue there because Limerick had possession.
Seamus Flanagan was onto the ball and you could have still have allowed the free to continue.
You come back and you book him afterwards. Dermot Burns taking this. Dermot Burns puts it over and that's his second pointed free of the game. 1 point the margin. Tense and tight. Barry Hogan from Killadangan up to the opposing 45-metre line. Waiting for it here is Sean Finn. Blocked well by Noel McGrath. Finn goes again. Weaves his way in and out of would-be challenges. Fouled. Free for Limerick. They're in a hurry. 10 minutes remaining. This one to be taken again by Dermot Burns.
And Dylan Quirk probably a little bit lucky there, Marty, not to be, with the way yellows have been dished out. He's probably lucky not to be receiving one.
Well, he's just on his own 45-metre line, Dermot Burns. Now, can he score? He's dropping it in. Runs in all the way. Gillan goes down. They prod the ball away, and it's out over the end line, and it's gone for another 65. This time it'll be a Limerick one off Seamus Kennedy's stick. Moment of concern, deep concern that time in that Tipperary defence.
Yeah, I think it was just a hoop, Gerard. I don't think there was much. Maybe there was a little trip, though. Is there a hand trip there? Yes. Liam Gordon was right there.
He thought so, that's for sure.
Yeah, I think there may have been a hand trip.
So in the follow-up, it's got to be Burns again. And there'll be a big cheer if this goes up and over. And he's put it over the bar. It's his third, and the teams are level for the fifth time. And in the remaining 8 minutes plus stoppage time, who's going to prevail?
Yeah, what if Tip got left now, you'd have to say. They've thrown the kitchen sink at it. Yet they find themselves level with 8 minutes and injury time to come. Can they go up now and eke out a couple of scores?
And they're trying to hold on to their own puck out and they have lost it. And Aaron Gillan tries to scoop it past Barrett and that's never going to be easy. Barrett wasn't in place as we saw when Gillan did score his goal. He wasn't marking him at that stage. Otherwise, he's done a right good job. Barry Hogan way downfield. Over the head of Bowe, collected brilliantly by Sean Finn. A way out as far as Declan Hannan, the captain. Moves it smartly away towards Conor Boylan. Boylan chasing after this one. Getting there ahead of him, however, was Craig Morgan. And Craig Morgan and Boylan having a fair old scrap over there. And the linesman, Patrick Murphy from Carlow, says line ball, which will be this time to Tipperary.
Yeah, fantastic catch by Sean Finn. He's really come to the fore, as he always does in the last few minutes. Boylan and Craig Morgan, who know each other from underage, really getting stuck into each other. Joe Brown has finally run out of petrol, and he's coming off. So, fresh legs for the last few minutes.
And the fresh legs belong to Dan McCormack. Hit in, and won well. Stakelham. One for Barry Heffernan to go pursuing, but beaten for pace. Line ball will be to Limerick. The pressure will be back on Tip again.
little unlucky from Conor O'Donovan. He did great to win it. He's been everywhere. He's playing at midfield now. And for a guy just, you know, for his first kind of big start, he's really been into play.
Garrett Hegarty. Oh, clever by him. Now, what's he going to do with it? Smart. Tom Morrissey. Back in field again towards Hegarty. Little interplay here, which has got a result in a shot by David Reedy, and up and over the bar. David Reedy puts Limerick ahead in the 65th minute.
Yeah, sheer persistence. They made a good few mistakes in it, and tipping is unlucky that one broke against off Robert Byrne, but they stay at it, Limerick, and they now go ahead, and the Gaelic ground's alive.
Maybe not the tidiest, but an accomplished finish. Mark Keogh, only 1 point in the game so far for Keogh. Is there more in Tipperary? Will Limerick have their measure yet again? Dara O'Donovan, challenged there by Stakenham, feeds it forward. Garrett Hegarty again, gives it on to Declan Hannan. And Hannan hits and scores! Declan Hannan in his 49th championship match puts two between them. There were two down at half-time, they're now two up.
Yes, reminded me a bit of a match a couple of decades ago, during a bit more with it, where you know, Limerick come with a surge. Hannan of all people.
Here's Dan McCormack. Has he got a response? Not just yet.
Yeah, and a lot of the tip lads seem to be running on empty. You wouldn't expect it to be Dan McCormack. He's just on, but Limerick doing all the hard running in the last few minutes.
Tip will be hoping that Dan can give the kind of response now that he gave down in Walsh Park a couple of weeks ago when he came on against Waterford. But they're under pressure, and it's Conor Boylan again, raiding, leaving it behind, going a second time. Still Boylan, grounded, free in. An opportunity to put three between them.
Yeah, and rightly so. There's some people that argue that he's kind of dragging in Craig Morgan, but Craig Morgan's two hands all over him there, and I think Liam Gordon calls it at that stage, and Boylan battling for everything since he came on, anxious to get in there on a full-time basis.
It'll be Aaron Gillan looking for his second pointed free of the second half, a shake of the head by Craig Morgan in front of a huge crowd here at the TUS Gaelic grounds in Limerick. Concluding stages of this match. That one is fired over the crossbar. So that's a goal and five by Aaron Gillan. Kian Lynch would love to be out there playing. His colleagues are doing it in his stead. And they look, at this stage, to be favourites to take the 2 points and to make it to this year's Munster final. Down towards Flanagan it comes. Great ball, clipped inside here. Boylan lets it drop, but gets the stick to it and finds the net. Substitute Conor Boylan ensures victory, I think, now for Limerick in the 67th minute.
Yeah, great work by out the field and spotted Flanagan loose. He dropped it. Great skill by Boylan to recover it. You'd say he shouldn't have dropped it, but left hand on top, one-handed, diving, manages to get there and put it past Barry Hogan, and that is game, set, match. Two goals, and they have responded as only champions can respond.
Well, they were put to the pin of their collective collar, but they have responded, and responded very positively. Richie English is now on in place of Dan Morrissey. So it's good to see Richie getting an opportunity. Noel McGrath gave great leadership. Boylan comes in quickly, wins it, or tries to. And then it's Tipperary again who regained it with Dan McCormack.
Yeah, they haven't been as smooth as you'd like, but of course, the regular stuff stays going there. They just won't quit it. Kyle Hayes picking up a yellow, but Boylan out after getting a goal and putting in a tackle and making a turnover there. Noel McGrath's looking out towards the stand to know will he drop it in and what he do. I think probably better serve to take his point. They put in a huge shift. They just haven't had the strength and physique maybe to just live with Limerick down the stretch.
That stronger panel that Limerick have got certainly was a major factor here. Noel McGrath gave outstanding leadership and tremendous play as per usual. That is 12 points in this match by Noel McGrath. 5 points the margin, 220 to 21 points. And we're in the 69th minute. Some more changes coming on for Limerick. And Oisin O'Reilly, number 34, comes on in place of Kyle Hayes. All of it very important in the learning process for the younger players. Garrod Hegarty again, back to Morrissey. It's shooting practice at this stage. They're in the driving seat and he's got four. Now it's back to a six-point game again on the call of the end of the 70 minutes.
Yeah, and him getting four, Ger, like you say, it like that is ominous for the rest of the country because it's only a matter of time for he'd find form. Full back line have been rock solid as well. Mike Casey, another huge shift beside Finn.
Dara O'Donovan driving it in, and it's another one for you-know-who, Aaron Gillan.
Yeah, but we said earlier, Ger, you can't be caught out in front of him. Kyle Barrow, I think, is arguing that he played the hurley here, but he's just as lethal in that position. You must be behind him for those balls, and he finishes it calmly, and nightmare stuff really for the Tipperary fans, because while quite not like last year completely, but still 9 points in it now from where? Unbelievable.
Aaron Gannon got 2-6 against Tip in the 2020 Munster semi-final. He's got 2-5 today. Coming across here to collect Craig Morgan. Away by Barry Heffernan. It really isn't a 9 point game based upon what we saw for most of the match. For certainly a good hour. Seamus Kennedy looking over his shoulder. Maybe they could be in for a late score with. Oh, that time it was Mark Keogh foiled, and Limerick get away with it again.
Yeah, there's a free back, but they weren't conceding the goal. And twice he's been forced to come one and one with a player, and twice he's shown probably why he is the best in the business. Nicky Quaid, incredible goalkeeper. Mark Keogh will feel he should have done better, but at the same time, guts and bravery off the line, and what a distribution type player he is. JP, I'm sure, will be delighted watching it.
Because in the last 10 minutes of the game, he's seen Limerick score 2-5 to Tipperary's one solitary point. I'm sure Noel will try to have a go at this one. Noel McGrath, that's the view from inside. Had a go anyway. There was a bit of a follow-up as well, but it didn't produce anything for Michael Breen. 65 the outcome. Well, next Sunday it'll be Limerick playing Clare in Ennis. On the same day, Waterford will host Cork, and the round robin part of the Munster Championship will conclude in 2 weeks' time. Tip will be at home to Cork, while Clare will play Waterford.
Yeah, and Tip have given their supporters a lot to think about for the future. Today, the performances of some of the younger brigade are very promising. Morgan and Stakelham and Brown, and Noel McGrath rolling back the year. So, you know, I know they haven't managed to finish off the job, but they've shown an awful lot of fight and real pride in the jersey for their fans, and their 20s were very good during the week. Great game with Limerick in the under 20. So hard enough scoreline to take from a Tip point of view, I suppose.
And for the record, that was Noel McGrath's 13th point out of Tipperary's tally of 22. Limerick looking for more. Not quite sated yet. Final 70 seconds or thereabouts. Cathal Barrett. Barry Heffernan. That's only as far as David Reedy. Held up momentarily. And Limerick will now be looking ahead to the clash with the neighbours from Clare in Ennis. That'll be some match next week, Anthony.
Yeah, looking forward to that. The town will be rocking because there isn't a ticket to be had for love nor money already. So, Clare going well so far. So that'll be the ultimate test next week.
Line ball by Dara O'Donovan. Collected here by Seamus Kennedy. And now the team is just playing out the remaining seconds here. Nice catch. Declan Hannan. Reedy again. Has a couple of players to aim at. Ooh, asking a little bit much that time of David Burns.
That's the worry for everyone, Gerard. There's been a fair bit of that today, sloppiness, but they're still, you know, well in control when it counts in the game, and they'll get that right, don't worry.
A match where Limerick started really, really well, played some lovely slick hurling. Then for a long time, this Tipperary team with Robert Byrne trying his luck with a late, late point here. They gave as good as they were getting, but in those final 10 minutes, the bench, the strength of Limerick, the power they possess, the brilliance as a team was seen to full measure. And as you can see, they are, after finishing and winning, 8 points to the good. And there can be no arguments about it at the end. It may look unfair on Tipperary, but John Kiley did what he had to do with his team. They had a journey to make and a job to do, and they did it really well. So they march on. They're in the Munster final with a game still to go. Colm Bonner, I think, will be very proud and pleased with the overall performance of his team. He was looking for a performance, Anthony. He got a performance.
Ah, he did. He got it in spades. They were excellent. And they just didn't have it in the legs, I think, the last 8 to 10 minutes. That Limerick machine just wore them down, Ger. And they'll be disappointed with the scoreline, but there'll be a lot of pride. Limerick march on. They're true to the Munster final now. And as I said all along, Kiley, once he won the last match before this one, he had it in his hands about where he, what games he targets, and lots of ways now he has the work done in Munster. So well, let's see what kind of a team he'll pick for next week.
And Limerick will be hoping as well, I'm sure, to get through this championship with a minimum of fuss in the terms of the number of matches that they have to play. So getting to a Munster final is important. Winning it's important, because that would take them through to the All-Ireland semi-finals and avoid all the other games.
Yeah, they're still a very young side overall, but when you're on the road a good while, the least amount of matches, the better. And that's what they'll be targeting now, is go the front door, win Munster final now that you're in it, and take it from there straight to the semi.
Well, that's how it's gone here in the TUS Gaelic grounds in Limerick. The teams were level on 5 occasions, and in front of an attendance of over 27,000. It's Limerick 3-21, Tipperary 22 points.
Thank you, Gerard. Thank you, Anthony. So Limerick not at their magnificent best, even in that second half, but they still did enough to come away with a good win in the end. So they are top of the table, 3 wins from 3 into the Munster final. Clare, of course, facing Limerick next week, their second best at the moment. And Tipperary, despite 2 out of 3 decent performances so far, they find themselves on no score. Shane, Limerick weren't brilliant throughout that match, but I suppose, is it this typical, stereotypical hallmark of champions to get the job done when it needs be?
Yeah, possibly. You know, a huge amount of time with Joanne, myself and Liam kind of say, look, there it is again in relation to Limerick doing stuff that's un-Limerick-like. But in the last 15 minutes, like we were just saying, that it looked as if Tipperary were running out of steam, and that's where Limerick really showed their experience, and they pushed on in the last 15 minutes. And it's great to win when you're not playing well, because, you know, for large periods of that game, it was in the melting pot. I mean, if someone picks up the paper tomorrow morning and reads the scoreline, they won't get a fair reflection of the game, because credit goes to Tipperary. They were really, really good for large periods of that game.
Given all the obstacles they have faced in the build-up to this, given the fact they were facing a team of Limerick's ability and what they're on the back of, 2 defeats and the difficult position they found themselves in, were you actually quite proud watching Tip out there, despite the outcome?
No, I certainly was. They gave it everything, Joanne. I mean, you could sort of feel the energy. Like Limerick are so well conditioned, it's really hard to stay the distance with them down the home straight for 70 plus minutes. You know, because they have massive reserves. You know, they had to call in all those reserves today. So Tipperary can be hugely proud of the performance they gave. Their supporters came in here wondering what was going to happen, but like, you know, the people of Tipperary need to get behind this team, because there's some really good young players coming. They didn't really see it through in that second half, but they were right in that game up to the final 10 minutes. And as I said, you know, Limerick have just that habit of getting goals at important times, and they've done it again today.
But even before the goals came, you could kind of see Limerick beginning to creep their way back in, and a few key scores along the way that saw them build up a little bit of a deficit.
Yeah, you can. You know, they picked off some really, really great scores, in fairness to them, you know. You know, and they had that element of composure, and I think you know, Tom Morrissey, and in fairness to, you know, they actually had just had a goal chance here that Kyle Hayes didn't get. The ball was poked out, was caught by Mike Casey, and they drove up the field through Barry Nash and struck the ball over the bar. And I thought they worked some really, really good scores. And this is a guy now that, to me, is starting to come into a bit of form. This would be a concern for every team in the Championship, because Tom Morrissey got three wonderful points. He got 4 points today. He's really starting to find his form on that pitch. And that's going to be a big challenge for some of the other teams in this competition, that's for sure. And I thought as well, you know, when David Reedy came in and when Conor Byling came in, they made a real impact. John Kiely will be really, really happy in that regard.
And it was just interesting. You see Declan putting the ball over the bar there, Joanne. And previous to that, Barry Nash with the ball over the bar. And it kind of comes back to what I was saying before the game. When them lads are able to push up the field, it brings a different element to the game. They didn't do it in the first half, but they did it in the second half, and then they got their just reward. So I think if Morris is still in the stadium, I think he now knows who the All-Ireland champions are. Anyway.
For anybody who missed it at halftime, that would be Morris from Timbuktu. Yeah. And as Liam was saying, the All-Ireland champions getting the goals at the vital time. Funny enough, you two reckon that Cathal Barrett was in contention for man of the match, and yet Aaron Gillan ended up with 2-5, I think it was.
Yeah, and in fairness to Cathal, for the first goal that Aaron got, he wasn't on it, but he played really, really well. But, you know, Seamus Fanning getting a ball across to Conor Boylan, and that's what Limerick didn't have in the first half. They didn't have that space, when that's what we were coming talking about, Tipperary possibly getting tired and running out of steam, and that them gaps opened up or whatever. So, as Liam said, when Conor Boylan came on, he was really, really good and got on the ball and got in a number of tackles. And again, just like what we said at halftime as well, trademark Aaron Gillan, where he stands in behind the man. Dara Donovan arguably goes for a shot here, I don't know, it dropped short, great catch, and it was a carbon copy of the first goal, and we have seen that time and time again over the last couple of years.
What a fetch it was. What a pass, opening pass from Grod Hegarty in the lead up to the opening one as well. Now, when we were talking about man of the match, Cathal Barrett was in the conversation for a long time there as well. So was another Tipperary man, but it was a Limerick man you went with in the end.
Yeah, it was. Noel McGrath reeled in the years again today, you know, outstanding leadership, orchestrated everything. But you'd have to say that Limerick, you know, they didn't have their finest hour today. They were under pressure for a long time in that game, but Mike Casey stood solid on the edge of that square. Some of his defending is of the highest order for a guy that's only coming back into his first term. You know, he's been outstanding, and he's going to be a hard nut to crack in that inside defence, and he's fully deserving of the award today.
Back from injury and bang on for Mike Casey, the Borgosh man of the match, and he is now with Damien.
Mike, congratulations, a huge battle. What was it like to play in there from a defensive point of view?
Yeah, like, sure. We knew Tipper coming here with nothing to lose. It was always going to be a massive battle, like, you know. We can only focus on ourselves. Tipperary, you know, they're a hurling county with full of pride, you know, so they were going to come, give absolutely everything, and they did that today, you know.
Was it hard to ignore all the outside talk, because they say the hurling public were there, Tipperary don't have much to play for, you know, Limerick will win easily. Is it hard to block that out, Mike, even with all your experience?
It is and it isn't, like, you know, we can only focus on ourselves, that's all we can do, you know, and that's the sort of kind of group we have, we only focus on ourselves, right? No matter what's going on outside, we can only control what we can control, and that's what we tried to do today, you know?
Just in the first half, there was a lot of wides, but nobody seemed to panic, and in the second half, the chances came. What was the message at the break, Mike? Was it just to be a bit more sharper, a bit more clinical in possession?
Look, it was just settling on the ball. So we've been here, we've done it, so we know what it takes. So just settle on the ball, go back into our groove. We were maybe trying to do a bit too much at times, just settling, and thank God we did in the second half.
A load of high ball, direct ball went into you guys, but you cleaned up very well today. Just personally, what's it like for you to be back playing again, to be back fit again? It can't have been easy just to miss out.
Yeah, look, it was a long, hard 2 years for me, like, you know, and every time I get to put on the jersey, it's just full of pride, like, you know, and I'm just delighted to be out there with all, you know, my best friends, like, and just hurling for Limerick again.
Okay, well, you are the Borgosh Energy Man of the Match, Mike, in the Munster final. Congratulations.
Thanks, guys. Thanks a million, lads. Thank you.
Yeah, brilliant to see Mike Casey back in action as well. Now, the groundskeeper here in the Gaelic Grounds may want to look away, because there were over 27,000 people here today, and most of them do appear to be on the pitch as we speak. What a day. What a time it is for the people of Limerick. Things really going their way at the moment. That is our hurling done for now, though. A big thank you to Shane and to Liam. So no upsets in the Gaelic Grounds then.